الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم. أما بعد, أحببت في الله, a question was asked. Assalamu alaikum. My friend is from Afghanistan. He lives in Dubai. And we both study in the same university. He is now thinking to shift to Canada to study so that after a certain time he gets the Canadian passport, and it would be an advantage as the passport is strong and it will help him in business and other travel ease. So what is the ruling on this? Is it permissible to go to a Kafir country for the sake of obtaining a passport and coming back to Dubai? Barakallah fikum. Wa fikum barakallah. First and foremost, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, "Inna ma'amalu binniyat wa inna malikulli mri'in manawa." Verily, actions are tied to the intentions, and everyone shall get that for which he intended. And then the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam extolled the importance of hijrah and hijrah to Allah wa Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sallam. And this hijrah, as is understood by the Salaf al-Saleh and the scholars of the Muslims in general throughout Islamic history, is that hijrah is from disbelieving lands to believing lands, or from sins to leaving off sins, or from the land of bid'ah to the land of sunnah. Similar to that. So I don't know of any fatwa in the past from the Salaf, this Ummah, up until today of Ulama of Ahl Sunnah, meaning Ulama of the Mutamassikina bi Kitabillah wa Sunnati Rasulillahi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, ala madhhab as-salaf as-salih. I don't know of anyone, nor even a lot of the other groups and sects, like whether it be a Deobandis and various Sufi sects. I don't know of any of those scholars who say that this is kind of this is permissible in the past. Now, in more contemporary times, you have scholars probably of Ikhwan al-Muslimin and some other groups and sects that make that permissible for those very reasons and say there's maslaha and there's this and so on and so forth. But as far as the asl and the ulama sunnah, and even in contemporary times, I don't know of any of them when they've been asked this question and many questions around this countless times that say that it's permissible. Even for the ones, for example, the Syrians who are suffering in Syria, I don't know of any scholars of Ahl Sunnah that say, yes, they should make this perilous journey to Europe and make hijrah from Syria or whatever, instead of going to a Muslim land and being a refugee. So I don't know of any scholars who say that this is permissible. What people do, that's what people do. But as far as making that permissible, I don't know of anyone from Ahlus Sunnati wal Jama'a who says that these types of things are permissible, especially as far as going to get jinsia. If it was just going to study, this is something different. But going to study and then to get to nationalize in a particular country, non-Muslim country like Canada or America, I don't know of any ulama that say this is permissible. And we ask Allah the Almighty to accept our good and forgive our evil. Wa sallallahu wa sallam ala nabiyyina Muhammad.